At this time, turning our attention to the home side of the field, 20-yard line, we will have the official welcome. Representing PSJ North Early College High School, Student Council President, Mr. Ethan Hernandez.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Ethan Hernandez, and I'm honored to be the student body president for the 2023-2024 school year. On behalf of our principal, Ms. Lisa Diaz, our faculty, family, and student body, we are excited to be here tonight in support of the Mighty Raider football team. To kick off this game, we would like to wish the Chargers good luck and, as always, an injury-free game. The Mighty Raiders would like to appreciate and thank all the organizations that make Friday Night Lights possible. We wish great luck to our cheerleaders, Raiderettes, and band. We are grateful to our coaches and directors for all they do, and of course, our parents for all their support as well. Thank you, and may the best team win. And as always, long live PSJ North!
At this time, with a response representing Brownsville Veterans Memorial High School, we have Ms. Annie Cisneros, Student Council Representative, Basketball Team Captain.
On behalf of Veterans Memorial Early College High School, we would like to thank the PSJ Raiders for their warm welcome and hospitality. We are excited to play in this memorial game where two top Valley teams meet yet again. Regardless of the outcome, we pray for an injury-free game and wish everyone safe travels home. And remember, go Chargers!
Sports officials, sometimes you love us, sometimes not so much. But the fact is, the game you're watching right now can't be played without us. Do you have what it takes to be an official? Are you willing to step up and give back to our student athletes? Why not join the 15,000 Texas Association of Sports Officials members that are dedicated to help make Texas junior, middle, and high school athletics the very best? Never officiated before? Don't worry. TASO will provide you the training you'll need. Why not make your first great call by contacting us today at TASO.org. That's
TASO.org. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, if we please rise as the Brownsville Charger Band will proudly perform their school's alma mater. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, please remain standing as your state finalist PSJ North Raging Raider Band will proudly perform our school's alma mater.
Thank you.
At this time, ladies and gentlemen, please rise as we will present our nation's colors. The PSJ North JROTC will be presenting our nation's colors this evening. They are under the direction of Sergeant First Class Sebastian Rivera and Sergeant First Class Jorge Brondo. Presenting the United States flag and commander, Cadet First Sergeant Sadie Garcia. Presenting the Texas flag, Cadet Captain Diana Flores. At left guard, Cadet First Sergeant Angel Acuna. At right guard, Cadet Private Mia Johnson. Singing our national anthem this evening will be PSJ North Raider Choir member Zoe Lopez. And at the 30-yard line, presenting our national anthem in American Sign Language, PSJ North varsity cheerleaders Camila Villa and Jimena Villa. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, everyone please rise, remove all head covering as we honor the greatest country in the world in the singing of her national anthem.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air,
afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to PSG ISD football. That's right, folks. It's time for some Friday Night Lights. We are at the beautiful PSGA Stadium, where tonight the hardworking crew at KTRI proudly bring you a regional semifinal matchup between your very own PSG North Raiders and the Brownsville Veteran Memorial Chargers. The Raiders are led by their head coach, Marcus Kaufman. JC Ramirez is the head coach for the Chargers. I'm Javi Martinez, bringing you the play-by-play action. Of course, with me is Jonathan Gongora, my good buddy. Jonathan, it's good to be back here with you. I'll tell you what, if you're not excited by the promo at the start of this intro, that's awesome.
Yeah, you know.
Veterans will be receiving.
Yeah, most definitely, Javi. It's going to be a great game. We're in for a great game. Both teams, of course, deserve to be here. Both teams deserve to be here. You look over at the Veterans Memorial Chargers. They come into the game at 10-2 overall. PSGA North Raiders coming to this game 12-0. Both teams looking to advance to the next round. Winner will play the winner between Corpus Christi Miller and Victoria West. So I think we're in for a great treat. Both teams are a run-heavy offensive team. The only exception, PSGA North likes to air out the ball. I expect a lot of that today.
Well, it should be very, very interesting, as you mentioned. Both teams kind of mirror themselves. The only difference, of course, is the passing game that the Raiders bring with Ale Aparicio. And that may be the biggest difference in this ballgame. Jonathan, you know, it all depends on how these two teams factor out. These two teams are no strangers. They met last year in this exact same round in the regional semifinals, but over in Brownsville. It was a gloomy day. It was raining. It was about 40 degrees. It was football weather. We got great football weather this evening, but no rain. So will that play dividends in today's ball game? Who knows, but we're about to find out.
Yeah, you know, both coaches pretty much have the same message for their teams the entire week. Just do what you got to do best. Play their game. Both teams are definitely different, and that was the message all week long to their teams. Just definitely going to be a great game.
Well, the Raiders come in representing District 16 5A Division 1 as champions. 15 5A Division 1 as champions, while Brownsville Veterans represents District 16 5A Division 1 as champions. So we got two district championships going after it here with a chance for a berth to the regional finals. And we are underway. It's a pooch kick, and it is fielded. And the onside kick is made by the Raiders. Now, he jumped for the ball. It appeared from up here that it did go past the 10 yards. If it did, that should be Raider football, but there is a penalty flag.
Yeah, I'm not sure that ball. That
official timeout for an injury.
Okay, so we're going to have an official timeout for injury. Now the debate is, and here it is.
Coming off field number 13, Josh Pettis.
Good news, the player walks off.
Kick catch interference. Kicking team number 12. 15 yards. First down.
Let's welcome our anchor partners, Freedom Bank and Junior Supermarket, proud sponsors of PSJ Athletics.
Well, here we go, folks. Right off the bat, a penalty against the Raiders. But, you know, of course, we got an eagle eye view. I thought it was a legit play, but instead it's a 15-yard penalty. So the Chargers will start at the Raiders' 39-yard line. And on first down, they're going to keep it on the ground. The Chargers are going to make good headway up to the 35, gain of 4 on first down.
Yeah, I mean, you know, and the Raiders are going to have a difficult time stopping this triple option. It's a triple option reason. You got three options. I believe we see here the Freedom Bank replay on that run. That's going to be number 22, Alvin Trevion.
So Trevion with 4 yards on first down, second down, another big running play, this time around the far sideline. Good job, the Chargers right there with their speed. Gilbert Trio gets a Charger first down, and the Chargers are quickly on the march here.
Yeah, as we see here in the Freedom Bank replay, again, that triple option is hard to stop, Javi. And, you know, the Raiders are unfortunately, we're not able to recover that onside kick. But and you give the Chargers good field position.
Right.
You're going to have to, you know, buckle down defensively, you know, find what you can, and you're just going to have to wrap up.
Well, after a 4-yard gain, now a 9-yard gain. Chargers are going to air it out. Quarterback looks, pumps, fires. He's got a man open, and that'll be a touchdown for the Chargers. A quick strike. A bullet of a pass from 26 yards out. That completion was made to Jerry Gomez, and the Chargers take advantage of a botched kickoff attempt right there, an onside kick, and the Chargers quickly score.
Yeah, Javi, as we see here, a great job right there by that offensive line, giving him enough time. And, you know, unfortunately, number four, Brian Guerrero, was trying to come up and make a defensive play. And in that situation, you can't try to deflect that, or you can't try to intercept that. You got to try to get up there and deflect that pass. And, you know, a great reception right there, great concentration by number 10, Jerry Gomez.
Well, Montoya with a touchdown pass to Gomez. And you know, what did it? I know what you're talking about, Jonathan, but what did it was that pump fake. You know, he pumped, the receiver was at about the 5-10-yard line. That throws a defensive secondary man, and then Gomez bursts into the end zone. A picture-perfect pass from Michael Montoya, and the Chargers with an extra point later. 10:57 remaining here in the opening quarter. They lead 7-0.
Yeah, Javi, and if you listen to the stadium, this side of PSJ North is quiet. We have the window open.
Yes.
And I think with that touchdown right there, it kind of backed up the Raiders a little bit. You're not used to playing from behind. I don't think they've played from behind the entire season.
Thank you to our founding partners, Raising Cane's and the City of Far.
Well, good point, Jonathan. You know, as far as the playoffs go, you know, we were here. Donna scored quickly on the opening kickoff to start by district action. So the Raiders have fallen behind in the playoffs. Let's see how they do this week in the regional semifinals as they find themselves trailing 7-0. They're going to get their first opportunity, though. Good solid field position at the 31.
And coming into this game, Montoya with 886 passing yards, 13 touchdowns.
Well, make that number 14. He's a dual threat quarterback. We've seen him run the ball. We've seen him pass the ball. On first down, the Raiders are going to test the heart of the defense. And the Raiders win that battle, gaining about 6 strong yards up to the 37-yard line. So good punishing run on first down.
That's going to be Ethan Guerra on that carry right there, Javi. A great job by that offensive line.
Replay by Freedom Bank.
Well, after a Freedom Bank replay, it'll be 2nd and 4. Raiders with an end around to Fuentes. Fuentes has a convoy of blockers. Fuentes follows that lead blocking all the way past midfield, up to the Chargers 40-yard line. Great execution right there by the Raiders.
Yeah, and I like this play call right here, as we see in the Freedom Bank replay. Right off, you know, right out of the gates, you come with a little trickery, a little end around, and just kind of gives a little bit of spirit back into your team, you know, as your defense is trying to, you know, relax themselves on the sideline, you know, seeing something that they have not seen before. A great job right here by the offense.
Yeah, great lead blocking by Marcus Rendon and the center, Dirk Vecchio.
Both starts. Offense, number 78, 5-yard penalty. First down.
Well, we're going to have a penalty, the second, and they're both against the Raiders. So the Raiders now have been penalized 20 yards in the ball game. Of course, if joined in late, the Chargers recovered the onside kick via penalty. 3 plays later, a 26-yard touchdown pass, and the Chargers convert the extra point. They're up 7-0. The first time the Raiders have the ball, they start this drive at their own 31-yard line, and now do we have a turnover? And we do, folks. The Chargers have come out storming this evening. Chargers take over at their own 43-yard line.
Yeah, I'm not sure I really like that play call right there, Javi, because you're throwing to the wide side of the field. And I understand that you're trying to get, you know, you're trying to get something down the field, but, you know, it's a great job right here by the Chargers. And, you know, Rendon just has to try to hold on to that ball and not try to make too much happen.
But Rendon, with a couple yards, not much more than that. But more importantly, the Chargers with a 7-0 lead. They have the ball now at their 43-yard line and a 7-0 lead. Nice little cushion for the Chargers on first down, that rugged black shirt defense. So keeps the Chargers to a minimal 2-yard gain up to the 45. Well, the Chargers slowing it down. It'll be 2nd and 8. Of course, this is their second position. They had a short field to work with, only 39 yards. They converted a touchdown 3 plays later. They're going to give it to the speedy giver, Trio. And Trio's going to manufacture a yard, maybe 2, up to the 46. So they're going to give him 1, and that's it. So the Raiders defense is starting to clamp down on this running game.
Yeah, as we see here on the replay, just a simple toss pass right there, and a great job by the converted defensive back, Matamoros, on that tackle.
Yeah, Andre Matamoros does a superior job sealing the edge right there, not allowing the speedy running back to get around the edge. Makes an open field tackle, 3rd and long, first 3rd down situation for either team. It's an end around. The Raiders read it well, and they're going to buckle down and get to the ball carrier about a yard short of midfield at the 49-yard line. And, of course, that was Jerry Gomez with the carry. It'll be 4th and 4 upcoming after a 3-yard pickup.
Yeah, the Chargers trying to come with a little trick of their own, but a great job right there by number 1. Leroy Palacios and number 2, Devonta Espinosa, not biting on that flow.
But it'll be 4th down. The punt unit is out for the first time for either team. The Chargers will be punting from their own 35-yard line. The deep man for the Raiders inside his own 15-yard line. Good snap, rugby-style punt. It's a high end-over-end. Everybody backs away from it wisely. The Chargers are going to down it at the 30. So that's where the Raiders will take over for their second position of the ball game, trailing 7-0 with 8:07 remaining in the opening quarter.
Thank you to our premier sponsors, La Quinta Inns and Suites, FAR RGV Medical Center, and FAR Crime Stoppers.
Well, the Raiders are going to take the field. First time they move the ball onto the Chargers side of the football field, but the Chargers forced a turnover after a reception.
Prior to the snap, timeout. Brownsville veterans, this is their first of the half.
Timeout by Memorial Funeral Home.
Attention football fans and travelers. Experience the all-new La Quinta Inn & Suites RGV Medical Center. Newly remodeled rooms, top-notch amenities, and unbelievable hospitality. Book your stay now at La Quinta Inn & Suites RGV Medical Center, located at 4603 North Cage Boulevard in FAR, where comfort meets luxury.
Well, there you go, folks. After a couple of commercial breaks right there, we have the first time out of the ball game called by the Brownsville Vets Chargers with 8:04 remaining. And that's how big this ball game is. You know, you got the lead. You know, you got the Raiders 1st and 10 from their own 30 after a punt. But things didn't seem to line up correctly for the Chargers, perhaps, and they were forced to use a timeout.
Yeah, you know, Javi, and that's a great timeout right there, it's, as you mentioned. And only because you don't know. You might have been missing a person.
Yeah.
We're not too sure why the timeout was called. But, you know, nonetheless, a great job, great timeout right here. You kind of settle your team down. I think that's more of a settle your team down timeout.
Well, from the I formation, the Raiders power football. They're going to bounce it outside. A lot of running room. And off to the races are the Raiders. And they're still running. Guerra, is anybody going to catch him? He's got 10 more yards. The 5. Goal line touchdown, Raiders. 70-yard jolt. My goodness, just what the doctor ordered for the Raiders as they drove 7-0. That makes it 7-6.
Javi, just as Guerra flexes his muscle right there, he did it last week also, rushing for over 200 yards. You know, and it all starts with the front lineman. And as we see here on the Freedom Bank replay, a great job. And I believe that was number 63, Aiden Guerra, Agustin Renteria on that seal block. And wow, what a great run right here by Guerra, right?
Well, Guerra opened up the second half last week with a 75-yard touchdown over at Cal Allen against Victoria East. That set the stage for the second half, and right now the Raiders have stormed back with 7:52 remaining in this first quarter. It's the Raiders 7, the Chargers 7. Here's a Freedom Bank replay.
Yeah, I think the only thing, Javi, is as much as you want to celebrate it, as much as you want to do all of that, you know, it's a lot of game left to play. And you also don't want to put the game in the referee's hands, as we see here. That was also a great block by number 24, Fuentes. Not sure, number 10 also had a good block. That was Julius Arredondo, and a great job right there by Guerra, just getting to the sideline and not looking back.
Well, a big touchdown run, and that was a great seal block by number 65, Aiden Sanchez, as well. And, you know, interestingly enough, I talked about Aiden Sanchez last week because, you know, Jason Montes was out of the ball game. Sanchez was used as a fullback. I'm not sure where he was on that play. We got a long vantage view from here, from up on top. But in either case, the Raiders have evened it up. And I'll tell you what, Jonathan, it's 7-7. I figured this to be a low-scoring defensive struggle. We're just over 4 minutes into the ball game, already 14 points. So the Raiders are going to pooch kick it. Chargers are going to return it from about their own 22-yard line. Little seam, little breathing room right there for the return man. Good return for the Chargers. They're going to have excellent field position once again, this time from their own 35-yard line.
And going back to what you mentioned about Sanchez, I don't know if you read what RGV Sports had put out on him, but he said, hey, I had one job, and that was to blow up the guy in front of me. He said that was the only mental note I had, create space, blow up the guy in front of me. He did a great job last week.
Classic line right there. You got one job. That's to go hit the other guy in front of you. Find somebody, get a good lead block. And there we see, folks, just a tremendous view. Packed house here on the home side. And on first down, not much doing.
Yeah, as we see here on the Freedom Rank replay, a great job right there by number 73, Salvador Sanchez.
And again, that was Alvin Trevillon, the workhorse for the Chargers. Picking up one, up to the 36, second and nine for the Chargers offensively. On the ground, quick hitter, Trevillon, muscles forward. Going to get close to the 44-yard line. So a good 8-yard pickup, but still 2 yards shy of the first down are the Chargers. First down marker sits at the 46, so it'll be third and two upcoming for this Charger offense.
Yeah, big third down right here for the Raiders. Defensively, Javier, stop would force the Chargers to punt.
Well, the Chargers 0 for 1 on third down conversion so far. See what they elect to do. They still have about 10 seconds on the play clock as their quarterback, Montoya, regathers his troops here. Going to have to hustle now. At 5, they do get it off. It's a give up the middle. Good run right there. And again, it's the hard bruising Alvin Trevillon fighting hard up to midfield. He needed a couple, gained 6. That'll be a big first down for the Chargers. That'll keep the drive moving. And that's important, you know, if you're a Brownsville fan, the Chargers have got to answer every score the Raiders do. I know the Chargers have a great defense, but the Raiders can put up points. The Raiders come in averaging 46 points a game. The Chargers a little bit over 35. So it's going to be perhaps a back-and-forth affair. It's yet to see. Of course, we're barely halfway through the first quarter. The quarterback looks under pressure, and Garcia right there, Danny Garcia. Gets to the quarterback, shoves him down. That's about a 5-yard quarterback sack right there.
Yeah, that's a big sack right there for the Raiders because the Chargers were getting a little bit of momentum. And Garcia just off a stunt, coming in unblocked and just so strong, Javi, able to muscle his way down, muscle the quarterback down.
One of the most fearsome defensive ends in the Rio Grande Valley. And, of course, his brother is a bookend on the other side. So pick your poison. You either want Dante or you want Danny Garcia. It's a give-up run right there. The Raiders at it again. This time it's Guerra. And Guerra gets snuffed out right at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a loss. I think forward momentum is going to get him to the 40. So gain of one by Guerra. But the Chargers defense go flying after Guerra on that play. So after a big run by Jason Montes, the Charger defense up to the task on first and 10 from the 41. So it'll be second and 9 now for the Raiders from the charge up from midfield up to the 47. Gain of 3, positive 3 yards, 2nd and 7 upcoming. And we are under 30 seconds, so this may be the final play. that we see before the end of a very, very fast-paced, very exciting first quarter. Of course, it's a proud production of KTRI. We are at the beautiful PSJA Stadium the day after Thanksgiving. Nothing better than football after Thanksgiving. When you're a high school athlete, a football player, regional semifinals, what's at stake? A chance to go to the regional finals.
Yeah, you know, PSJ North looking to go back-to-back years, and Brownsville veterans looking to go back for their first
time.
That
is the end of the first quarter. Hydration. Timeout.
The bonds we create with our pets can be powerful. A man's best friend really isn't just about dogs, but about any animal companion that brings us joy and unconditional love. Losing a loved one is heart-wrenching, but losing a pet can be just as difficult. Unconditional love deserves unmatched service, which is why we offer pet services for those special pets that become a special part of the family. We serve all the members of your family.
Well, back, folks, welcome back to PSJA Stadium, proud production of KTR. I'm Javi Martinez. With me is Jonathan Gongora. Jonathan, one quarter in the books in their 5A Region 4 semifinal game. Brownsville Vets on the road, the visitors, wearing the nice, pretty white tops, blue helmets, red pants. They lead the PG North Raiders 14-7.
Yeah, and the Chargers trying to return their favor from last year, Javi, of course, you know, was. We mentioned we were there covering that game, and the Raiders came out victorious at Sam Stadium. Chargers playing away. They say they love playing away. They get
yes.
They say they do a lot better. We saw that last week. They were able to knock off Corpus Christi Veterans.
Well, to start the second quarter, it's a pitch out, and the Raiders with a bruising tackle, but not before the ball carrier, Mark Samano, gets his first carry. Samano's going to get up to the 43-yard line. Good gain of four. That's going to bring up a very manageable third down, third and three to be exact. Here we see on the juniors replay. A little bit of running room, and I can see why Samano was clapping his hands. I thought he had a little bit of a seam. It closed very quickly by that black shirt defense of the Raiders. Let's see what they do here. Quick snap. Trio is going to dive forward, and Trio needed to get to the 40. He gets to the 39, 4 yards by Trio. Good dive, second effort right there. And the Chargers' drive continues, and it's very interesting now. You know, we've always talked about the black shirt defense, the best defense in the Rio Grande Valley. But today they're getting tested. They're getting tested via the passing game, and right now the running game is working for the Chargers.
Javi, I think coming into this game, they were averaging only 100, giving up only 139 yards
yes.
per game. Today already at 150.
And that's only for, that's why exactly I bring up that point, and that you're not just the best color guy, but a good stat man as well. And just on cue, the Raider defense, they get in the backfield, make a tackle, but will that be a personal foul, a face mask, perhaps maybe a horse collar?
I think it might even have a late hit.
Well, we're going to find out. Or was it holding? Let's use both sides of the spectrum there. Anything is possible.
Personal foul. Unnecessary roughness. Defense, number 6. 15 yards from the previous spot. Automatic. First down.
Well, there we go, folks. And here we see the play. It's a give, and I'm not sure where number 6 made the penalty.
Replay by Junior Supermarket.
Well, they're going to move the ball from the 39 to the 25, so that's a 15-yard penalty. That's huge. First down once again. Yeah, well, there's a lot of extracurricular activity there. The Chargers get up from the 24, to the 23. Gain of one. So second and 9, the Chargers trying to get into the red zone. Right now they lead 14-7, just about 10 minutes remaining before the half. Quarterback looks, he's got a man open, he fires, and it's into the end zone. Oh my goodness, what an attempt right there. Almost a spectacular diving catch by Jerry Gomez. Jerry Gomez already has one touchdown reception on the day. Great pass right there by Montoya. Just let the receiver a yard too long.
Yeah, Javi, and you know it was coming, and a great job right here by the Chargers catching the Raiders off guard. And, man, Javi, just out of the fingertips of Gomez. And I tell you what, if he comes up with that grab, this game is 24-7.
Well, it's a toss on the outside. Trillo trying to get around the edge, and the Raiders are going to seal the edge, not before Trillo, because valuable yards. He's going to be about 2 yards shy of the first down marker, though. Pushed out of bounds is a speedy Trillo at the 16-yard line, gain of 7.
Yeah, as we see here again, just that triple option. And, you know, fourth down and two, an interesting play call right here, Javi, if you're the Chargers. You know, do you have a field goal kicker that could kick it from here, or do you not take that chance and try to keep the drive alive? Because if you don't, you've given the Raider offense enough time to make adjustments and get back into the field. Big fourth down.
I agree with Coach Ramirez on the other side over there. Go for it. Your offense is humming, and it is still manufacturing yards. And the Chargers do gamble, and they come up on the positive side. The Chargers are now 2-for-2 on fourth down attempts. And I think so. You know, right now you're playing your best football. You might as well live by it or die by it. And the Raiders almost force a turnover there. Good hard-nosed running by Trevion, but almost coughed it up. On first and goal from the 6, the Chargers are going to muscle their way up to the 4. Gain of 2. Now, this is huge now for the Blackshirt defense. You got to hold the Chargers.
Yeah, I think regardless, Javi, this is 4-down territory if you're the Chargers.
Yes, now it is, definitely.
And I only say that because, you know, you're playing against a really good football team who can come back and can stop you in a heartbeat. And if you're the Chargers, you have all the momentum rolling your way. You got to take advantage of it.
Well, it's a pitch. Trillo trying to get around the edge, and Trillo will get there. Trillo lunges in. That's a touchdown for the Chargers. The Chargers have come out storming here on a Friday afternoon at PSJA Stadium. They're shocking the world. They're shocking the PSJA community. They lead 20-7.
Yeah, and a great job. And again, it goes back to that triple option, Javi. You're not sure what to stop. You're going to stop the toss. You're going to stop the option. What exactly are you going to stop? And a great job right here by the Chargers, as you mentioned, storming out of the gate. That extra point will make it 21-7, Javi, in favor of the Chargers.
Well, Trillo caps off with a 4-yard touchdown run, a 12-play, 82-yard drive.
Champions don't settle for less. Knock out injuries with UT Health RGV Sports Medicine, the official sports medicine doctor for the UT RGV Vaqueros and PSJA ISD. UT Health RGV, keeping Vaqueros and you in the game.
Well, here we go, folks. The Chargers with 8:55 remaining here in the second quarter lead 21-7. You know, and the biggest development this game, Jonathan, you got to give credit to, though. Chargers are playing lights-out football. But the Raiders have a lot of work to do. They got a lot of time. They got 3 timeouts to work with, and they're going to start the next drive at the 25-yard line.
Order like a champ at Raising Cane's. We've got tailgates of hand-battered, cooked-to-order chicken fingers and cane sauce, and jugs of freshly made tea and lemonade. Raising Cane's chicken fingers, one love.
Well, here we go, folks. The Raiders break their huddle. They're going to take the ball at their own 25-yard line in a most auspicious spot, though, all year long. I don't think they've trailed by more than 7 points. They find themselves trailing right now by 14. And on first down, the Raiders are going to maneuver for a couple yards, not much more than that.
Yeah, I think if you're the Raiders, you just got to go with what's gotten you here, Javi, and that's the run game. You got to, you know, as much as you want to pass the ball.
Oh, there's still plenty of game.
There's still plenty of game. You got to keep the ball on the ground. You got to be able to stop the Chargers defensively, too.
Well, that's what it all is going to boil down to. As we said earlier, we alluded to earlier, that the Chargers need to match the Raiders' touchdowns. Well, now the story's flipped there. Now the Raiders have got to match the Chargers' touchdowns. Big run right there by the Chargers. by the Raiders. So the Raiders 2 yards away from picking up a first down up to the 33-yard line after gain of five. And it's going to be a run, and I don't think the Raiders picked it up. They need to get to the 35. They got up to the 34, gain of one. So the Raiders are now 0-for-2 on third down attempts, and that's been the biggest difference as well, Jonathan. The Chargers are 3-for-6 on third down attempts.
This is their second of the half.
Timeout by Memorial Funeral Home.
Well, the Chargers elect to use their second timeout with 7:37 remaining in the second quarter. And there we see a fumble right there. Junior's replay, the Raiders lucky to get the ball back. They're going to be a yard shy of the first down. The Raiders appear they're going to go for it, though, on fourth and one, deep in their own side of the field.
Yeah, and that's been about the second time, Javi, I've seen Aparicio get tripped up, and I'm not sure if he's getting tripped out coming out of the center or if he's getting tripped up with his running back. But, you know, something's got to happen. You cannot afford to give up the ball right here to the Chargers.
Well, fourth and one. The Raiders at the line of scrimmage. Chargers with everybody at the line of scrimmage. It's a big push, and Aparicio's going to break free. He's off to the race. He's got one man to beat, and that's Trio. The speedy Trio is going to tackle him down, though, at around the inside the 30, and that's a big run by Aparicio. He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage, but he had the whereabouts, the knowledge, and he breaks free up to the Chargers' 29-yard line.
Wow, Javi, what a tremendous athletic play right here by Aparicio. And you know, so Aparicio's lucky the ball didn't pop out right here because he had Trio coming from the sideline, you know, who hit him. And Aparicio just got to go down there, not take contact. And great job right here by the Raiders. Back in business.
That's a 37-yard run by Aparicio on fourth and one. Big-time football by the senior quarterback from the Raiders. It's a pitch. They're going to misdirection it, and the Raiders are trying to get around the edge, and Guerra's going to get shoved out of bounds, tackled about 4 or 5 yards into the bench area of the Raiders. No call, though. Gain of about four up to the Chargers' 25-yard line. So good gain right there by Guerra. I'll tell you what, Jonathan, this is becoming a very, very excellent football games, meaning, you know, it's a regional semifinal, but I think both teams are now getting that chip on their shoulder where they're going to say who is going to be more physical and who's going to win this football game. It's an end around, and Jaden Fuentes bursts through the seam. He's going to get inside the red zone, inside the 10, at the 9, 16-yard pickup by Jaden Fuentes. The Raiders are storming back.
Yeah, we see here, Javi, just Raiders going back to that counter play. A great job by Fuentes. And, you know, I think the Raiders got to do a better job of holding on to the football, Javi. Is, you know, they like to run the ball with one arm. But in a game like this, as soon as you get contact, you got to wrap two hands up.
Well, I tell you what, the key difference right there is the Chargers have some great speed. They're getting to the ball carriers, and they're getting to their on time to try to strip the ball. And I think that's a huge thing right there that we got to look for the remainder of this ball game. Ethan Guerra with a short run stumbles forward.
As we see here, you know, this entire drive, Javi, the Raiders went back to what's gotten them here, and that's the run game. And you know, luckily for the Raiders, Javi, they didn't get stopped because initially Aparicio got stopped behind the chain, and he was athletic enough to bounce himself out and take off for that 37-yard run, and the Raiders in position here to possibly put seven on the board.
Aparicio under center. It's a toss to Guerra. Guerra finds a seam. Can he get through it? Guerra's going to fight forward, and Guerra will be in. Well, one official saying touchdown. One is saying no. And the bar official says touchdown, and that's what it will be. Ethan Guerra from 8 yards out. The Raiders are back on the board, cutting the game in half.
Yeah, big-time drive right here by the Raiders, Javi, being able to, you know, overcome those two turnovers and put seven on the board. As we see here, a great job by that front line by number 65, Aiden Sanchez, and number 63, Agustin Renteria, making way for Guerra.
Isasi with the extra point, so we got 5:38 remaining in the second quarter. The Raiders just get on the board. It is now Chargers 21, Raiders 14.
Kids can be anything they desire. This is why school plays an important role that shapes their lives. Every day counts to make an impact in your child's life. My opportunities start at PSJA ISD.
Well, folks, it's an exciting one. Regional semifinals. Brownsville Vets leading PG North 21-14, 5:38 remaining, of course. Jonathan, Javi, you know, it's as even as it can get right now. The Raiders lead stat-wise with 204 total yards, and the Chargers with 172. But more importantly, the Chargers lead by seven on the scoreboard.
Yeah, Javi, it's definitely a great game. It's definitely a different game than last year.
Yes.
And that's one thing both coaches really emphasize, is that this game was not going to be like it was last year. As you mentioned, last year the weather could have, was it weather implication? Was it the weather that had implications on the outcome of the game? We'll never know. But here, the Chargers stormed out of the gate, you know, up 21-14. It could have easily been 28-7. You know, but the Raiders have done a great job so far answering back for the Chargers. You need one stop on defense, Javi, to get the ball back.
Well, we'll see if the Blackshirt defense can get that. The Raiders kick off. Chargers will have excellent field position after their return. They're going to get up to the 30. Raiders do a great job of getting to the ball. And the Chargers, 5:33 to work with. They only have one timeout. Raiders have all three.
Do you need fast, affordable internet? The City of FAR will be providing high-speed internet starting as low as $25 a month. And for PSJ households, you will receive free internet. Call 956-402-2000 for more information.
Well, the Blackshirt defense takes the field. The Chargers take the field offensively. This is a big drive. Either way you look at it, of course, the Chargers took the opening kickoff. The Raiders will take the opening kickoff in the second half. So the Raiders trying to get a stop. The Chargers trying to extend their lead before the half. And on first down, a good five-yard pickup by that offense. I'll tell you what, you know, the Chargers, they got 100 yards passing, 3-for-4 from off the arm of Michael Montoya. But they've got 77 yards running on the ball game. And as you mentioned, you know, the Raiders, they don't give up too many yards, but the Chargers are manufacturing yards. They're earning every bit of it. That's why they have a 21-14 lead. Another big seam right there. That offensive line for the Chargers is humming extremely well. The Chargers are going to get up to the 45. That's a big 10-yard jolt by the Chargers offensively.
Yeah, and the reason for that big push, Javi, is the fact that, you know, you have two or three guys chopping at the line, as we see here. Great run right there.
PSJ North. This is their first of the half.
Timeout by Memorial Funeral Home.
Well, we're back to live action. We're at the beautiful PSJ Stadium, proud production of KTRI. We're at a beautiful Friday late afternoon. We got 4:46 remaining before the second quarter ends, before the halftime festivities. But, you know, right now, Brownsville Veterans leading 21-14. I think everybody thought the number 7 ranked team in the state, PSJ North, would come in here, humble the Chargers. But, in fact, it's been the other way around. The Chargers making a lot of headway this evening.
Yeah, you know, and if you're the PSJ North Raiders, Javi, you've got to do just that. You've got to start humbling yourself because, you know, Coach Ramito said earlier, you know, those guys on the other side, they have a, they walk around with swag. They know they're good. But, hey, he goes, we're in the third round for a reason, too, because we're just as good as they are.
And absolutely true. The Chargers have earned their way here as District 16-5A Division I champs. The Raiders District 15-5A Division I champs. So two juggernauts getting after it on a Friday afternoon. And the Chargers cross midfield, gain of 6 up to the Raiders' 49-yard line.
Yeah, the Raiders need to find a way to stop the Chargers here, Javi, and possibly get an attempt to score some points before the half because, you know, fortunately for the Raiders, they get the ball to start off the second half, but you cannot afford to give up a touchdown here.
Keep it on the ground. with Trevillon are the Chargers, and the Chargers needed to get to the 45, and I believe that's exactly where they get. Gain of four, that'll be another Charger first down. That's the sixth first down of the ballgame for the Chargers. The Raiders have four first downs. So even though it's a high-scoring game, it's been tough sledding for both teams. Every yard has been hard-earned. An interesting way the Chargers set up. I'm not even sure that's legal when you think about it. The Chargers are going to keep it on the ground, and once again, this time it's the other Garcia, Dante Garcia, making a tackle in the backfield back at the 49-yard line. That's the third tackle for a loss for the vaunted Blackshirt defense. And the reason I say that, Jonathan, as we see a great penetration by the Raiders defense, the linemen, correct me if I'm wrong, they've got to line up to the shoulder of the center. And maybe it's the angle we're at, but I don't think they are. Quarterback's going to pass, and the pass is complete, and a big run after the reception. Once again, Jerry Gomez doing an excellent job receiving the ball. Big time pickup up to the Raiders' 29-yard line. Big pickup of 20 right there.
And again, Javi, that should have been a minimal 5-yard gain, but, you know, trying to come up and make a big play was Andre Matamoros, and unfortunately, he slipped off yes. of that tackle and allowed Gomez. And Gomez is a big receiver. He's not small, so you're going to have to go low on him.
Well, the Chargers take advantage of that missed tackle. They're going to get a lot of yards. They're going to keep it on the ground. And this time, stymied in the backfield. The Raiders snuffed that out completely. A great job right there by Ethan Montemayor in the backfield, tackling the ball carrier back at the 35, loss of 6.
And this is a better job by the Raiders. A great job right there by number 99, Danny Garcia. You know, slow playing that. Then you have number 28. Ethan Montemayor taking the pitch man, and that's what you got to do. You got to take away the pitch man and the guy with the ball, because if you attack the quarterback, that's an easy pitch for him.
So Trevillon loses 6 yards. He's at 12 yards on 10 carries. Quarterback with a quick swing. It looks like a double pass, and it will be. Man is wide open, and Trio is going to catch it. Trickery by the Chargers. Excellent play call at the right time. And the Chargers are now up 27-14 with under 2 minutes remaining in the second quarter. 35-yard touchdown pass to Trio. That's Trio's second touchdown reception of the ball game.
Yeah, as we see here, Javi, just a quick pitch out right there to Sosa. And Sosa was a beautiful pass to Trio, and that's a play that you practice, Javi. That's a play that you practice every single day. You just wait. You just wait until the perfect opportunity to call it, and that's a perfect opportunity to call it right there.
It sure was, and they worked it to perfection, and that is why the Chargers are now doubling up the Raiders, 28-14 with a minute 54 remaining.
Yeah, anybody who's watching or anybody who's here, Javi, I'm sure did not expect the Chargers to be up 28-14 as we see them taking the field for this kickoff. And I think even we're stunned too. You know, we expected a great game, a hard-hitting game. But yeah. I didn't expect the score to be 28-14 in favor of the Chargers.
Well, I figured this would be a very tightly contested football game. You know, these are two champions going at it, a berth to the regional championship. But right now the Raiders find themselves down by 14. They got a minute 54 to work with. They're going to get the ball at their own 25-yard line, and they've got two timeouts to work with.
You know, if you're the Raiders right here, you're not in a bad spot. You have an opportunity with a minute and 54 to go score 7 points. You're going to receive the ball in the second half. Mm-hmm. A touchdown opening up the second half puts you at 28-28. So you got nothing to worry about, but you have to put together a touchdown drive right here.
Well, it's a two-for-one deal. The Raiders can score, and as you mentioned, receive the ball in the second half and get themselves right back in this ball game. But right now, Aparicio scrambles. He's going to get hit, and there comes the ball loose. The Raiders are going to pick it up. They're going to run forward, and the Raiders are going to possibly get to the 21. Not much more than that. So a second fumble by Aparicio.
And again, Javi, the Raiders going back to the running to the passing game. That was possibly three turnovers off the passing game. I think you just got to stick with the running game here. And if you're up at Eastern, you gotta know where that pressure's coming. And I tell you what, the Chargers are doing a great job defensively of putting pressure on the quarterback.
Well, it's obvious the Chargers did their homework. They're playing to perfection here as they lead 28-14. Quarterback keeper and a fine job. In fact, that was the Darren Garcia with the ball right there. Garcia back to the line of scrimmage. And the Chargers right now, I know it's early, 51 seconds, but I think they're starting to smell blood, Jonathan. I think these Chargers really getting after the Raiders.
Brownsville veterans, this is their third and final of the half.
Timeout by Memorial Funeral Home.
Well, we got 48 seconds remaining before the half. The Raiders are going to face a third and long. First down marker sits at the Raiders 35, the ball at the 21, so third and 14 to be exact. Jonathan, you know, you've got two timeouts, 48 seconds to work with. You get a bit aggressive here on third down.
Well, here's a problem, Javi, is that it's third down and 15. Mm-hmm. If it was, you know, a second and short, maybe a third and short, you could be a little bit aggressive, but it's third and 15. You almost lost, you lost the fumble, or almost lost the fumble the first first play. The second play, you lose a couple of yards. Now you're in third and 15. The Chargers can force you to punt the ball as they have.
But it'll be Aparicio. He's going to wing it out, and it'll be short of his intended receiver. So Aparicio is now 1 for 3 in the ball game, passing just for a couple of yards. And as you mentioned, that means the clock stops. More importantly, for the Chargers, and the Raiders are going to have to be punting. Now, the Chargers don't have a timeout, though.
And we saw this last year, Javi. We saw that the Raiders got down, and, you know, they really hadn't played from behind throughout the entire season. And we saw what happened. It was in the latter part of the game where they just couldn't catch up. And I hope that's not the situation here where, you know, they're down 14 points. And as we see here again, another bad play. And you got to get rid of that if you're Guerra, Javi.
Well, Guerra does not get the punt off. And unraveling a little bit before the half are the Raiders. The Chargers are going to have excellent field position at the 7-yard line. And you know what? A score here by the Chargers, and all momentum is going to be on the side of the Chargers, and a big point and a big lead on the scoreboard. Just a high snap. Guerra does a good job of corralling it. He was hoping to get a punt off, but could not. And because of that, it's a turnover on downs. And the Raiders are going to force to be calling their second timeout of the half.
This is their second of the half.
Timeout by Memorial Funeral Home.
So the Blackshirt defense, they call a timeout. Right now they find themselves trailing 28-14. You know, stat-wise, you know, it's about as even as they can get. Raiders, 202 total yards. The Chargers are 246. The biggest thing, though, is the two turnovers. The two turnovers are looming huge right now for the Chargers. And the other thing is the Chargers have not been penalized yet. The Raiders have been penalized three times for 35 yards. And, of course, you know, if you nitpick, John, you know, the opening kickoff, the Raiders gambled. I thought it was a clean play. Obviously, it was not. And the Chargers came out with great field position. A couple plays later, they took the lead. I think, in all essence, that may be the biggest play of the football game right there.
Yeah, you're right, because the Raiders, you know, essentially might have the ball and possibly 7 points on the board, as we see here. Going to the air, almost interception by number 28, Ethan Montemayor. Wow, what a big interception that would have been, Javi.
Montemayor with a spectacular play right there. The intended receiver looked like he was open for a second. Great job as they receive full extension. Diving effort by the Chargers, Jaden Fernandez, I believe. But more importantly, number 28 for the Raiders, Ethan Montemayor, makes a spectacular play defensively. It'll be second and goal, 29 seconds before the half. Let's see if they give the ball here to Trevillon. They will not. Quarterback Montoya looks, passes, and that's going to be incomplete. So back-to-back incomplete passes by the quarterback. Great job right there by the Raiders. We see Steven Garza right there. And Mikey Gonzalez both in the mix.
As we see here, that's a great pass and almost intercepted right there by number 7, Steven Garza. And, you know, great job right there by number 1, Leroy Palacios. You know, getting in there, still playing defense.
So it'll be third and goal from the 7. Two incomplete passes off the arm of Montoya. He is now 4 for 8 for 155 yards passing. More importantly, he's got 2 touchdown passes. The Chargers have 3 on the day. And a drop pass in the end zone. Gilbert Trillo could have put the nail in the coffin in the first half, but instead it's a drop pass. It's an incomplete pass. It'll be 4th down upcoming.
That's a big play right there for the Raiders, Javi, because that was essentially a 21-point lead for the Chargers going into the second half, to the end of the first half. But, you know, I think giving up only 3 points here and the position that they were in is better than that 7 points.
Most definitely.
Nonetheless, points are points for the Chargers, and they need all the points that they can get.
Well, this will make it a 3-possession game. The kick is up, and there's a lot of hitting going on in the backfield where the kicker was. No penalty flag. The kick is through the upright, so with 17 seconds remaining before the half, Brownsville Vets, the Chargers 31, PG North, the Raiders 14. Well, the Chargers do their job. They had the ball first and goal. They would have much rather have liked a touchdown. The Raiders did their job. They could have ill afford a touchdown. They held the Chargers to a field goal. So count that as a win for both teams. It's 31-14 with 17 seconds. It's been a crazy football game. We've seen a lot of craziness. Are we going to see a crazy comeback by the Raiders in the second half?
Yeah, and that's what everybody's hoping for, Javi. If you're here at the stadium, that's exactly what you're hoping for. That's what you're going to need. You're going to need a 17-point comeback in the second half. You're going to have to make some stops defensively. You cannot expect to make a comeback if your defense can't stop this Chargers offense.
Well, interestingly, you know, when you only average 4 points a game in 12 ball games, that's 48. The Chargers are near that. They're at 31 points already in one half. The fleet-footed Jaden Fuentes avoids a few tacklers, gets finally tackled at the 33, but we do have a penalty flag on the return.
During the return, illegal block in the back. Return team number 8. 10 yards from the spot of the foul. First down, PSJ North.
Javi, and also one of the other big differences is the 45 yards of penalties for the Raiders. That we saw it against Donna. They had, you know, a lot of penalty yards, and you can't do that, Javi. In a game of this magnitude, you cannot have that many penalty yards because you got to win in all aspects of the game.
Yeah, and right now the Chargers, without any penalty yards, they force a couple turnovers. That's the biggest difference as well. On the ensuing play, Fuentes is going to keep it. He's going to stay in bounds, get bottled up right around the 25-yard line. So gain of 7 by Fuentes, but that won't do much. And there we hear the final buzzer. The first half is over here from beautiful PSGA Stadium, proud production of KTRI. It's the Chargers 31, the Raiders 14. Stick around, enjoy the halftime entertainment. We'll be back for the second half.
The Halftime Show is presented by Mockingbird Transport.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Veterans Memorial Early College High School proudly presents the award-winning Chargerettes dance team under the direction of Valerie Camargo-McHale. Please welcome your 2023-2024 Chargerettes! Taking midfield are officers Paola Saldivar, Regina Trevino, Vanessa Luna, Eva Snelson, and Valeria Peña. Co-captains are Chloe Ibarra and Jolie Medell. And your 2023-2024 captain is Coral Garza.
Of Charger football under the Friday night lights. But now it's time to get off your seat and get on your feet. It's halftime band time. Now taking the field is the award-winning Veterans Memorial Early College High School Charger Band. The Charger Band is under the field direction of head drum majors Luis Aranda, assistant drum majors Joshua Galt and Jose Guajardo. Color guard captains are Sharon Mendieta, Ariana Muniz, Dele Escobedo, and Alyssa Matamoros. For this halftime performance, we present two South Texas stand tune favorites featuring two talented Texas All-State Trumpet Seniors in Victor Lopez's Salsa and Chimps. And now the Charger Band will conclude with another fan favorite. With all the thousands in attendance, Land of a Thousand Dances. The Charger Band is under the field direction of Elizabeth Stone, Ryan Clark, Edna Sierra, Eduardo Ontiveros, Julio Salinas, Erica Casanova Garza, and Miss Brianna Guetta. And a big thank you for all your support to BISD Interim Superintendent of Schools, Dr. Jesus Chavez, Deputy Superintendent, Dr. Nereida Nelly Cantu, High School Area Administrator, Dr. Norma Ibarra Cantu, Administrator for Fine Arts, Michael Garcia, Instrumental Music Supervisor, Sam Rodriguez, School Board Members, Jessica Gonzalez, President, Daniela Lopez Valdez, Vice President, Secretary Denise Garza, Members Carlos Elizondo, Eddie Garcia, Frank Ortiz, Minerva Pena, The Veterans Memorial Principal, Miss Norma Jean Canales. Stillman Middle School Principal, Sandra Cortez. Stillman Band Directors, Victor Franco, Margo Meave, Olga Manzano, and David Ramirez. A special thanks to the Veterans Memorial Administrative Team, our teachers, and of course, our parents. A special thanks to our hardworking band boosters for their commitment and continued support. Good night, and as always, go Chargers!
PSJ North Early College High School proudly presents the renowned 36-time national champion dance team, the PSJ North Raiderettes. Leading the Raiderettes on the field this year are Lieutenant Karime Gonzalez, Second Captain Alyssa Sainz, Major Tatiana Ruiz, First Captain Luisa Martinez, and Lieutenant Dulce Garcia. This week's Raiderette of the Week is Dalisa Oriano. The Raiderettes under the direction of Joey Aguillon and Vanessa Martinez. Take it away, Raiderettes! Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the true pride of the Tri-City District, your PSJ North Raider Band! The Raider Band is a 7-time UIL Area G marching finalist and a 3-time UIL State marching band. Color Guard co-captains Mia Hernandez and Jocelyn Diaz, and Color Guard captain is Brian Pinon. The Raider Band is under the field direction of drum majors Jose Cervantes Martinez and head drum major Isabel Espinosa. For tonight's halftime entertainment, the Raider Band will be performing X's and O's. Ladies and gentlemen, put your nachos down and your hands together for the PSJ North Raider Band.
The Halftime Show is presented by Mockingbird Transport.
Test, test.
Welcome back, folks, from the Halftime Entertainment, and welcome back to PSGA Stadium Regional Semifinal here in the 5A Division I bracket. It's your Raiders and the Chargers, and here we see some highlights, and their Chargers quarterback brings it down, throws it up for grabs, but it's a touchdown to start the ball game. The Chargers started the game 7-0.
Yeah, as we see here, Javi, a great run. This is going to be the run by Guerra on this first touch with a 70-yard scamper. And you know, this is the way that the Raiders needed to – this is my opinion, the way the Raiders are going to win this game, Javi, is by keeping the ball on the ground and stop trying to go to the air. As we see here, number 22 on that carry for the Chargers. A great job defensively for the Raiders.
And there we see again number 99, Garcia, with a quarterback sack. Both Garcias had a quarterback sack, but Michael Montoya, quarterback for the Chargers, throwing a beautiful pass, and he's thrown two touchdown passes, one to Gilbert Trillo. He's been effective, and there we see Garcia again, just making great tackles for the Raider Blackshirt defense. But the big thing, Jonathan, has been the opportunities that Chargers have had passing the ball, and they've executed extremely well. Then, you know, of course, they got Trillo running the ball, and they've got another good Alvin Trevallon run the ball as well. And then we see Aparicio, who had a big fourth down play for about 30-some yards. That's been the biggest play of the ball game for the Raiders.
Yeah, it's, and like you mentioned, Javi, it's been very tough for the Raiders. As we see here, that's that throwback pass from Sosa.
A bit of trickery, yes. 2-3-0, and then an extra field goal at the end of the half, and that pretty much sums up the ball game. You know, we're going to head to the start of the third quarter with the Chargers leading 31-14. You know, the Chargers come in from Brownsville Veterans Memorial as District 16 5A Division I champs. The Raiders, the hosts here in the regional semifinals in District 15 5A, they are the champions as well. So two very good football teams getting after it. Last year, the Raiders beat the Chargers in this very same regional semifinals, 35-15. Right now, it's a lot of work for the Raiders if they want to get back. And if you're a Charger fan, well, you got a big cushion, and the Raiders are going to take the opening kickoff of the second half and have very good solid field position.
Yeah, and I think if you're Coach Kaufman, your message to the Raiders at half is, hey, let's go back to playing our type of football. Let's be aggressive. You know, the Blackshirt defense needs to step up. The entire season, Javi, the Raiders gave up only 42 points.
Right.
They've already given up 31
in this game. 31 in one half. And first half yardage, the Raiders with 210 total yards. The Chargers with 246. Four first downs for the Raiders. Chargers had 10 in the first half. And on first down, a little shovel pass, and the Raiders are going to make good headway, but get bottled up before they make a big play. Good run there by Guerra. Guerra gets about 6 to 7 yards up to the 42-yard line.
Replay by UT Health RGV.
So Guerra picks up 6 yards, and he has now 9 carries for 101 yards. Last week he had over 200 yards rushing, and Guerra's going to get a lot more to his rushing total there as he crosses midfield, gets thrown down at the 45, but not after picking up 13 valuable yards.
Yeah, great job right there by Montes on that lead block, and you know, a great job again by Guerra. And you know, if you're the Raiders, you got to keep this momentum going, Javi. You can't slow things down. You gotta put up points quick, and you gotta get your defense to do what they've done all season, and that's stop teams.
Well, it's a 17-point deficit for the team with the ball right now out of I formation. This quick hitter right up the gut, and the Chargers defense right now, they're wailing a little bit. The offensive line for the Raiders has come out very strong to start off the second half. Big 7-yard pickup once again.
Yeah, Javi, and it's crazy. I went down at halftime, and it's everybody's stunned down there. Everybody's stunned. It was quiet. It's just everybody looked like they had deer in the headlights, though, because they did not expect the game to be like this. And I tell you what, the Chargers have done a great job matching the Raiders play for play.
Well, I think the play-for-play matching has been how physical this game has been. The Chargers said they were going to come in and bring a physical brand of football. And so far, it has been quite evident.
False start. Offense, number 18. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
So, 5-yard penalty will back up the Raiders. It'll be second down still. It was second and 3. Now it'll be second and 8. That's penalty yard number 50 for the Raiders in this ball game, while the Chargers have yet to have a penalty flag thrown against them. Very interesting. 50 yards to 0 on penalty yards. And on second down, the Chargers defense just stymies that play right at the line of scrimmage. Montes just had nowhere to go right there. Montes back to the line of scrimmage. Not much more than that. Third and long upcoming for the Raiders.
And you know, I was watching an interview on Valley Central, and the center for the Chargers said it, no one has hit the Raiders in the mouth, and that's what we got to do. And I tell you what, they've been doing that the entire game. We see a big third down here for the Raiders.
Raiders 0 for 3 in the ball game. There's going to be a penalty flag before they get this attempt off.
Illegal snap. Offense, number 56. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
So that'll push the ball back to the 48-yard line. Of course, the first down marker sits all the way at the Chargers' 35-yard line. And I was about to say, the Raiders are 0 for 3 on third down conversions. They are 1 for 1 on fourth down conversions, but 0 for 3 on third down attempts. And this is a big one here for the Raiders, starting off with their opening drive of the second half. Quarterback is going to fire, and that's going to be incomplete as the quarterback just really gets harassed in the backfield. Nowhere to go. Wisely throws it incomplete. It'll be fourth down.
Javi, and you know what? The only reason that this drive even stalled was because of the penalty yards.
Yes.
And we have been talking about it all season long. This has been the Raiders' problem, is that they have penalties when they don't need to have penalties. And, of course, they've been up in games, so the penalties didn't matter. But we talked about how there was going to be a game that the penalties were going to come back and haunt the Raiders, and it's been this game.
Well, they had two false starts. They had second and 3, and instead they're punting now, so that's huge. It's a lot of ball game, though, and the Chargers going to let this punt. Well, they're going to finally pick it up at about the 3, and the Chargers going to race out of bounds at about the 18-yard line. So that's where the Chargers will take over on their initial series of plays, starting the second half as they lead 31-14 with 9:12 remaining in the third quarter. Well, here we go, folks. The Chargers' first play is bottled up. In fact, it'll be a loss of a couple on the play. That black shirt defense, Jonathan, they got to get it done here in the second half, because in the first half, they got runned on. They got passed on. It's up to the defense to come up big, and the Raiders almost came up huge with a turnover there.
Yeah, Javi, this has been like the second or third play that they actually lose possession of the ball, and it's bounced in the Chargers' favor. Mm-hmm.
Well, it's a loss of 2, so it'll be 2nd and 12. And getting back to the original line of scrimmage will be the Chargers. They'll get plus 1, so they'll get to the 19. And, of course, that's the workhorse, Alvin Trevillon. He's got 16 carries on the evening, with only 59 total yards. The Chargers with only 90 rushing yards, 155 passing yards. On third down, they're going to air it out. It's a good pass and a spectacular reception. No, it is dropped at the very end. Almost making a great grab with Jerry Gomez. Fine defensive job by that secondary of the Raiders, batting that ball away. It'll be fourth and down upcoming now. So the Raiders, black shirt defense, they do the job. They force a 3-and-out. Let's see what the offense can do now.
Yeah, and Gomez actually.
That was close.
I think Gomez had the ball going down to the ground, and it fell out of his hand. And tell you what, that would have been a spectacular catch, because that would have set up the Chargers on a first down.
Ethan Montemayor with the coverage. That sets up a fourth down and a punt. Raiders deep man at about the 40-yard line. High snap, gathered well, blocked, and the Raiders do block the punt. The Chargers are going to return it. They're going to try to pick up the first down, eluded a couple of
and there
defenders,
it comes,
and that is the key. I am not going to speculate, but a penalty flag did fly. It'll probably be a face mask and an automatic first down for the Chargers. When Lady Luck is on your side, you are tough to beat, and that was huge right there.
Personal foul. Face mask defense number 5. 15 yards will be added to the end of the run. Automatic first down.
So the Raiders blocked the punt, but because of a face mask after the fact, the Chargers try to return it for a first down, and now the defense has got to step back on the field. See, they got enough men out there. Let's count helmets, silver helmets. I'm not sure they got 11. I'm assuming they do. So the Chargers retain possession, and on first down, they're going to race up to the 37-yard line from the 34. So the Chargers second down now. Now, the biggest thing out of this situation, Jonathan, is it's not so much a penalty. It's the fact that the Chargers get an extra opportunity with the ball to consume time. That means the Raiders can't make a comeback. That's the biggest thing about this scenario that just developed. And the Chargers don't care about a Raider comeback. They're going to try to put more points on the board. The Chargers, an explosive run up to the Raiders' 40-yard line. 23-yard jolt right there. Wow, that's big-time football by Alvin Trevillon, refusing to go down. He had about 5 or 6 black shirts draped all over him. They still couldn't get him down, piggybacking another defender for a ride.
And again, Javi, the Raiders have out-muscled everybody the entire season, and I tell you what, they're getting out-muscled today by this Charger team, who seems to have wanted a little bit more than the Raiders do, as we see a run here on first down.
Great job by Michael Montoya, the quarterback. He doesn't run the ball often, but when he does, it's very effective. And Montoya is going to maneuver his way, get around a couple of would-be tacklers inside the 30, down to the 28. So chunk yards now coming from the Chargers on the ground game. Pickup of 12 right there. And the other thing is, we look at the scoreboard, not necessarily the score, but we look at the clock. There's almost 6 minutes remaining, 6.5. So Chargers trying to extend their lead. The Raiders desperately need a turnover. They need a defensive stop here. Quarterback pitches it out. A lot of running room. Getting around the edge. The Raiders do a good job, but not before the Chargers get up to the 25-yard line. Gain of 3. Positive 3 yards right there for the Chargers, and they stay in bounds.
Javi, you know, and they got that stop. They got the stop that they needed.
Yes, they did. 3 and out.
But
amazing.
Again, penalties being the Raiders' downfall today.
Yeah, right now the Raiders with 70 total penalty yards. The Chargers, 0. Nada. So it'll be second down. Montoya gives a snap, and the Chargers offensive line really do a number right now on that defensive front. The Chargers pick up 5 tough yards right there. That's big bruising football right there, Jonathan. That's big boy football right there. Helmet against helmet, shoulder pad against shoulder pad. And right now, the team who seems to want it more are the Chargers. They're really barreling down the field. They're just tough to stop right now.
Yeah, and Trevillon is really taking a beating, Javi. Every time he comes out of the pile, he kind of shakes his head like, man. But I tell you what, he's running like a madman right now.
They're going to give it to him once again. That's his 20th carry of the ball game. There we see him kind of slowly get up. But after 20 carries, Trevillon picks up another Charger first down, and he's going to near the century mark rushing. So he gets from the 20 to the 14, does a running back. It's gain of 6. Trevillon now with 96 yards rushing. Taking the time are the Chargers. This time the change of pace, a smaller, speedier back. It's Maddox Bond with a second carry of the ball game. Bond does a great job getting up to the 10-yard line. gain of four. Bond with two carries has 8 yards. Oh, and Bond looks like he's a little bit shaken up. Let's hope that young man is okay. Had some helmet issues right there. We're quickly approaching the 4-minute mark of the third quarter. That means 8 minutes have elapsed very quickly here. And it's a scoreless game in the second half. This game came out of the half, 31-14. We are still at 31-14, but the Chargers are driving, and they're going to get another first down. Yes, they do. The Chargers dive forward inside the 5, possibly to the 3. Good run by the quickness and speedy Gilbert Trillo. Gain of 7. That's another Charger first down and a first and goal.
Yeah, and again, all the Chargers have done on this drive, Javi, is take advantage of that penalty by the Raiders. You know, they literally have marched 80 yards from where they started and are in a position to really take control of this game.
They're going to give it to Jaime Martinez. That's Martinez's first carry of the ball game. Nowhere to go, though. May have lost a yard. So the Chargers are second and goal from the 4. 3.5 minutes remaining in this third quarter. It's been a very lengthy drive after the Raiders actually had a 3-and-out. The Chargers punted. The Raiders blocked it on the return. The Chargers returned it, and the Raiders did them the favor of getting a face mask. And now Trillo jolts in from 4 yards out. The Chargers are overwhelmingly up on the Raiders now, 37-14. Trillo with his second touchdown rushing, and he's got 2 touchdowns receiving. The Chargers from Brownsville, I tell you what, they came in with the intensity, and right now the scoreboard shows it. The Raiders are kind of scratching their head, but it's getting late, so the Raiders better get something going offensively very quickly.
Offside. Number 1, defense. Half the distance to the goal. Try.
Well, offside, so the ball goes half the distance to the goal. On this extra point, the Chargers are going to still convert the extra point. I thought maybe they'd bring out the offense and get the two-point conversion, but instead, no, they settle for the extra point attempt, trying to make it 38-14, and it will be good. So there we go, folks, with 3:16 remaining in the third quarter. It is now Chargers 38, Raiders 14.
Thank you to our premier sponsor, FAR Crime Stoppers. If you need to report any suspicious activity, please call 787-TIPS. That's 787-TIPS. Thank you to our premier sponsors, The Wing Stadium and ACT-RGV.
Welcome back, folks. After a couple of brief commercial breaks, the Chargers score a touchdown. Only touchdown of the second half, 9 minutes into the second half. And it's been a craziness when the opposing team, you know, they get a blocked punt, but then they get rescued by a face mask, and then they continue to march down the field. They score a touchdown. So the Chargers taking advantage of every single break that has been given them today. And because of that, they are playing inspired football and have a 38-14 lead.
Yeah, Javi, you know, and that's one thing that I think is the difference between the two teams right now is that the Chargers are playing true to what their coach told them. Hey, it's just another football game. They get dressed the same way we do. Yes, we know they're a good team. Hey, but we deserve to be here too, and they're proving it today. They beat a very good Corpus Christi Veterans team last week, and now we know why they beat them, because they're a good team. We see them in person, and they're
definitely
very good. That triple option is very hard to stop. I tell you what, the Raiders have been killing themselves today.
They haven't been helping themselves, that's for sure. And the Raiders need to help themselves out here, as we're going to have a penalty or a timeout before the first play from scrimmage.
False start. Offense, number 8. 5-yard penalty from the previous spot. First down.
But the interesting thing with these false starts, though, it hasn't been the lineman. You know, it's been a receiver, somebody else other than the lineman. So, again, these are penalties that, you know, they're going to happen. But Right now, they're just happening at a very critical time and juncture in this ball game, and it's not helping the Raiders now. They're behind the sticks, first and 15 from their own 20. And the Chargers are going to pile on to the running back. No gain right there. That was Guerra. Guerra with 121 yards rushing on 12 attempts now.
And I tell you what, Javi, we talk about the black shirt defense, but I tell you what, this defense from Brownsville Veterans Memorial have
been tough.
Doing a great job,
yes.
You know, stopping the Raiders. And let it be, it could be possibly that the Raiders try to open up the passing game early. The run game wasn't there, as we see Aparicio here. It's going to swing it out to Montes. Going to be incomplete.
Oh, miscommunication there between the quarterback and receiver coming out of the backfield. Montes, the running back. So it'll be third down and 15. And, of course, the Raiders are 0 for 4 on third down attempts. On the ground. Raiders are going to pick up a couple yards. Maybe to the 21 is Guerra. Guerra comes up a little bit hobbly there. So it'll be fourth down. The Raiders are going to send out their punt team. You know, with 2 minutes remaining in the third quarter, not too much urgency right now from the Raiders.
Yeah, and I think at the same time, too, Javi, you know, a lot of people were talking about, you know, the Raiders going to state and the Raiders doing this and the Raiders doing that. I think everybody was looking forward to the next week instead of looking forward to today, as we see a punt here from Palacios. It's going to land at about the 47-yard line of the Chargers.
So that is where the Chargers will take over, leading by 24 points, a minute 32 remaining here in the third quarter. And if anyone is still interested, over in Corpus, is Corpus Christi Miller, the Buccaneers, 14, Victoria West, the Warriors, 7. And, of course, the winner of this ball game faces the winner of that ball game in the regional finals. The Chargers will pick up a couple yards on that play. Trevillon now with 98 yards rushing, the workhorse for the Chargers.
Raiders could use a turnover right here, Javi.
Quarterback is going to keep it. He's going to have a lot of running room. Finally gets tripped up, but not before he gets inside the Raiders' 40-yard line. Tackled down at the 37-yard line. 14-yard pickup right there by the quarterback. Good piece of running right there by Trio. Trio now with 37 yards. There we see in the UT Health Rio Grande Valley replay. Fortunately, the Montoya's leg didn't get buckled in right there. Felt kind of awkwardly.
And the big difference in this game, too, Javi, is the fact that the Chargers have been able to force two turnovers, whereas the Raiders have not been able to force a turnover as we're quickly reaching the end of the third quarter.
Well, Trio with that 9-yard pickup now has 107 yards rushing.
That is the end of the third quarter. Hydration, timeout.
The end of the third quarter has come. Three quarters are in the books. It is officially, after three quarters of play, the Chargers 38, the Raiders 14.
And I like what Veterans Memorial is doing right here, Javi, gathering up everybody at about the 50-yard line. Realizing that the game is on the line and that the Raiders can still march back and win this game.
Let's welcome our anchor partners, Freedom Bank and Junior Supermarket, proud sponsors of PSJ Athletics.
Well, folks, welcome back at PSJ A Stadium. KTRI brought to you by PSJ ISD. The Raiders hosting the Chargers in the 5A Division I Regional Semifinal game. A berth to the regional finals is what is at stake. Right now, the Chargers with the upper hand as they lead 38-14. They've got 12 minutes to work and hold this lead. Of course, they have the ball right now. The Chargers are going to pick up a first down all the way down to the Raiders' 21-yard line. Gain of 7.
As we see here on the replay, Javi, just a great job right there by number 24, Calvin Trevion, stretching that play out as much as he could. Great job by that front line also, Javi. If you look at them, they're definitely undersized compared to the Raiders, but they do a great job of getting out there and paving way for their running backs.
So a new set of downs. Chargers are going to work their way up to the 17-yard line. Gain of 4, so 2nd and 6 upcoming. 6-yard pickup. 2nd and 4. Well, officially it'll be 2nd and 5. From the 17, the Chargers taking their time. Around 15 seconds on the play clock, trying to milk as much time as possible. I believe we're going to have a false start or an offside. It all depends. The ball comes out loose. We're going to wait the call here.
Offside. Defense, number 12. 5-yard penalty. Results in a first down.
So it'll be penalty on the Raiders. That moves the ball to the 12-yard line. That'll be another 5 yards of penalty on the Raiders. And unfortunately, the Raiders now have about 90 yards of penalty yards, and the Chargers are going to try to race in there for a touchdown. That is number 24 getting his 2nd carry. Calvin Trevion with the carry from the 12.
Official timeout for an injury.
UT Health RGV is transforming healthcare in the RGV. From routine checkups for your family to injury care for your athlete, UT Health RGV has you covered. Discover the best in healthcare close to home at UT Health RGV.
So Calvin Trevion with a big gain. And then we see a good round of applause as the veterans player walks off the field. Trevion with a couple carries now has 15 yards. Ball sits at the Raider 4-yard line as we approach the 10-minute mark of the ball game. There'll be 2nd down for the Chargers. They can pick up the first down before they get into the end zone. First down marker is sitting at the Raider 2-yard line. So it'll be 2nd and 2 after an 8-yard pickup. And that'll be a touchdown for the Chargers. Maddox Bond, he's got 3 carries each for 4 yards. That means he's got 12 yards on 3 carries. But more importantly, he has a touchdown now to his credit. And that'll make it 44-14.
Yeah, Javi, and you know, the Chargers, It's crazy, you know, Coach. Excuse me, Coach Ramirez said it best. You know, we play a lot better when we're away. He says, "I love the facilities. I love the atmosphere. I love the fact that we're going to be able to play for both communities." And based, pretty much, he says, we're playing for the Valley. Whichever team wins here is going to represent the Valley, you know, in the fourth round of the playoffs. And, you know, may the better team win. And fortunately for him, it's been his team today.
Do you need fast, affordable internet? The City of FAR will be providing high-speed internet starting as low as $25 a month. And for PSJ households, you will receive free internet. Call 956-402-2000 for more information.
Well, with 10-1 remaining in the ball game, the Chargers have just extended their lead to 45-14. The Raiders are about to receive. And you're right, Jonathan. You know, one team was going to be represented from the Rio Grande Valley in the Region 5A Division I Regional Championship, and the other one's from the Coastal Bend area, and that's going to be either Corpus Christi Miller or Victoria West. Meadow leads West right now, 17-14. So barn burner on that side. But right now, the Raiders get the kickoff. It's a good one, and still on his feet is Leroy Palacios. Never any quit in that yet, young man. And he's still on his feet. He finally gets tripped up. Now we have a little bit of pushing and shoving, but it was all incidental on the play. Just a lot of hustle from Palacios.
Yeah, and again, Javi, this is just frustration coming out of the Raiders. You know, they've you know, I really think that coming into this game, they overlooked Brownsville Veterans. I think everybody pretty much did. You know, you saw what happened last year. You look at you look early on in the season. They had a similar opponent, and it was the PSJ Bears. The Bears were able to knock off Brownsville Veterans.
That was their last loss.
Yeah. Yes. Whereas the Raiders, you know, they were able to beat the Bears, you know, comfortably. Right. And so you kind of, you know, people speculate, well, they beat them at this time, and you know, whatever, but. You know, that was almost 2 months ago. Both
exactly.
teams have gotten a lot better over the last 2 months.
Yeah.
And I tell you what, Brownsville Veterans came to play today, and they're showing it tonight.
Well, the key difference is the, you know.
After the play, there are two fouls, one against each team. Unsportsmanlike conduct, number 44 of the return team. Unsportsmanlike conduct on number 16 of the kicking team. Those penalties offset. First down, BJ North. That is their first unsportsmanlike of the game for each.
So the Raiders will start at their 27. And I was going to say, Jonathan, you know, these two teams met last year with the Raiders winning 35-15. Both teams come back with pretty much the nucleus of their team. The only difference is, well, I guess we have no infraction there. The only difference is, of course, the Chargers changed head coaches. And maybe it took the Chargers a little while to gel. You know, they lost their first game to San Benito. Then they won a couple games, and, you know, they barely beat St. Joseph out of Brownsville. And then they lost to the Bears. But ever since then, they've been clicking. They've been playing extremely well. And obviously, you know, they have a great opportunity to advance to the regional finals next week. And we're going to have a couple more penalty flags. So this game is really slowing down now.
Full start. Offense, number 74, five-yard penalty, first down.
So the penalty will push back the Raiders to the 22.
And now in that quarterback, I believe it's number 10, Julius Arredondo. And I think that's going to be for the Raiders. You know, they're just going to come out and try to see what they can do in the air.
That'll be the 100th. Penalty yards for the Raiders, and a beautiful pass by Arredondo to Ethan Guerra up to the 44-yard line. Good pass right there by Arredondo of 22 yards. Better reception by Guerra. A little bit of life now for the Raiders. On the ground, it's Guerra. And Guerra's going to get tackled by about five Chargers right there.
Yeah, they're definitely feeling it now, Javi, as we see Guerra a little slow to get up.
Yeah, Guerra's a sophomore. No reason for Guerra to be out there. Guerra with a loss of one. Back to the 43. Good job by that offensive front. Beautiful pass by Arredondo. Reception made by Willingham. Down to the Chargers' 45-yard line. A little bit of magic coming out of the arm of Julius Arredondo, who was the starting quarterback at the beginning of the year for the Raiders. Did a good job. Then, of course, the returning quarterback from last year, Ale Aparicio, became healthy. And Arredondo became an integral part of that offensive line and a tight end receiving the ball for the Raiders. But getting his shot here at quarterback now late in the ball game is Arredondo. He's going to shoot. He's going to fire. He's going to miss his intended receiver, though, Jaden Fuentes. So that'll stop the clock. Make it a second and 10 for the Raiders. Clock stops at 8:12.
Yeah, Javi, you know, and something crazy was that, you know, Coach Kaufman and I were talking earlier, you know, before the game, and he says, you know, playing here is different. You know, the Raiders, this team in particular, right, and I'm talking about the seniors, they've been undefeated since their sophomore year, playing here at PSJ Stadium. Their last loss was against Edinburgh Vela, and he says, I just hope I didn't jinx it by saying that. And he kind of said it with a smile, and, you know, it looks like that's going to be what's going to happen tonight here as we see Arredondo air it out to Fuentes.
That'll be an incomplete pass. So third and 10 upcoming now. So the Raiders facing a third and 10, but before that, we're going to have a timeout by the Chargers with 8:04 remaining in the ballgame.
Brownsville veterans, this is their first of the half.
Timeout by Memorial Funeral Home.
Well, folks, the Raiders are facing a third and 10, 8:04 remaining. Of course, they're huge deficit. The Raiders right now with 272 total yards. The Chargers with 367 total yards. And one of the big factors is that the Raiders have lost three turnovers. And the Chargers converted those to points. The Raiders just haven't been themselves this evening as the defense has had a hard time. The Blackshirt defense stopping the multifunctional, though, very talented Brownsville veterans offense. They've come at you from different directions. They got some speed. They've got some hard-nosed runners. They got a quarterback who can run the ball and pass it. So it's been tough. The Chargers, of course, leading. Raiders not giving up, though. Big pass is completed to Guerra, but he is out of bounds. So that'll be an incomplete play. And that'll bring up a fourth down.
Hey, you know, and the Chargers is pretty much playing prevent defense. Just, you know, it's obvious that the Raiders are gonna throw the ball deep. They're just trying to get something going. I mean, they haven't been able to get something going since the second half. And as I mentioned again, you know, you start off the game with an onside kick, a perfectly executed onside kick, and for whatever reason, there was a fair catch interference call. The Chargers marched down and scored right away. The Raiders answered. Excuse me, the Raiders threw an interception. As we see Arredondo scramble out, try to just get rid of the ball. Ball is going to be way short of the reception. Going to be turnover and downs for the Raiders. And as I mentioned, you have a fumble. You're marching. You know, yeah. Rendon fumbles the ball. The Chargers go down and score again. The Raiders score. Get a three and out. Raiders get the ball back. And then they give the ball back to the Chargers on an interception. And it's just the Chargers defense came to play today, Javi. They did what they said they were going to do, and they said what nobody had done was that hit the Raiders in the mouth, and they've done that all game long.
Yeah, it's been a physical game. The Chargers overwhelmed the Raiders today, bottom line. The scoreboard says it, 45-14. You can't deny it. You know, hats off to the Chargers and, of course, their head coach, J.C. Ramirez. They came in with an excellent game plan. They've executed to perfection. They've taken advantage of the opportunities that the Raiders have given them. And the Raiders just, you know, they not their best day. They picked a bad day to play their worst football. And the Chargers are going to be triumphant. You know, I think it's safe to say it's 25-14. And they're going to be either facing Corpus Christi Miller or Victoria West in the regional finals.
Yeah, and I like what you just said. You know, this is the game that you could not be out of sync. And I spoke to Coach Kaufman, and, you know, that was the one thing he said. He said, you know, we haven't been able to play smart football, or not smart football. We haven't been able to play, you know, 100% every single thing. We either get, you know, penalties, or we can't pass, or we can't run. You know, and they've relied on the defense.
Yeah.
But today the Chargers exposed the defense.
Yeah.
They threw the ball early. As we see, they have 155 yards on the air. As we see, number 24, number 7 with a big hit. That's going to be Steven Garza.
Yeah, Steven Garza, the hitting machine right there, comes up with a big hit. We see on the replay. Good job. And then Garza just annihilates the running back there. Calvin Trevillon, he scored a touchdown. It paid the price on gaining a couple yards on that play. Great job right there by Brian Guerrero, forcing the running back in. And, of course, Steven Garza takes care of the rest. 3rd and 8 for the Chargers here. From the 47, and the Chargers are going to get cross midfield. And there's a fumble. And let's see who comes up with that scrum there. I believe the Raiders do.
Yeah, I do believe Steven Garza ripped him out of his hand.
That'll be the first turnover forced by the Blackshirt defense. So you're absolutely right. Steven Garza with a fumble recovery. He's playing extremely well.
As we see here, that's a new quarterback. Mm-hmm. That was going to be number 9, Sergio Sosa. Yeah, the ball just came loose. And, you know, unfortunately for the Raiders, the turnover is a little bit too late, this late in the ballgame. So you're down by 29 points. Excuse me. 31 points.
The Raiders will keep it on the ground, get past the 40. Of course, this drive after a turnover by the Blackshirt defense starts the Raiders at their own 44. They're going to move the ball down to the 37-yard line. Gain of 7. Again, the other thing is that you notice, you know, of course, these are all unofficial stats, but the Raiders with under 300 yards of total offense. They averaged near 500.
Yeah, great catch right there by Fuentes, but an even bigger hit. And that's just going to tell you how this game,
yeah,
you know, has played out the entire day, however, the entire night, is this Brownsville Veterans defense came to play today. And they said it right there, going to hit you in the mouth, and showing it right now.
Well, Fuentes makes a catch with a big-time hit by Jaime Martinez from the Chargers. It'll be a first down, though. Here we see on the replay, nice little toss. Then lighting up the receiver is Martinez. First down for the Raiders, though. They're going to go deep, and that is going to be caught in stride. Beautiful pass from Arredondo to Marquez Rendon, and the Raiders not giving up. They're in business. They're on the scoreboard. So with 5 minutes to go, the Raiders have cut into the lead.
As we see here, a great pass by Arredondo to Rendon. And, you know, Rendon just got behind the defense right there. And, you know, the Raiders, as you mentioned, not giving up, still fighting, Javi. And, you know, I know I'd like to say it, right? It's anything can happen. You're down. Mm-hmm. You're down 25 points. And I've seen games, and it's, I've seen games on YouTube where people come back.
Oh, yeah.
You know, with
you
a minute left.
Know.
They score 3 touchdowns with a minute left.
False start. Offense, number 56. 5-yard penalty. Try.
But when you can't stop someone defensively, Javi, it's going to be hard to have a comeback.
Well, that's a key right there. You got to get a defensive stop. And you can throw all kinds of stats out there, but the one that, you know, just baffles me is that the Raiders have been penalized 105 yards today. The Chargers, zero.
Yeah. You're getting beat on the penalties. You're getting beat on the turnovers. You're getting beat on the run game. You're getting beat on the passing game. The Chargers.
They've unlocked, you know, they've gotten a little bit lucky. And the reason I always say lucky is because, you know, on that block punt, they still converted it for a first down to be a penalty. So when you got all that working in your favor, well, you got a 45-21 lead.
And again, you know, the Raiders play whistle to whistle. They're aggressive from the start of the whistle to the end of the whistle. And that penalty, Javi, to me, was the game changer right there.
Yeah.
You had a face mask penalty that gave the Chargers life. They marched down 80 yards and scored a touchdown. But the penalty came from a play that there was no need to come in. There was already – he was already giving German out of bounds, and you got a defender coming in trying to quote-unquote, kill shot, and you come away with a penalty right there.
Yeah, it was still anybody's ballgame at that point, but the Chargers converted that. As I said, they've taken advantage of every single opportunity given to them this evening, and that's what championship teams do. When the opportunity is there, you got to strike, and they have done that, in fact, for several touchdowns. And right now they lead to the Chargers, 45-21. The Raiders have just scored. Let's see if the Raiders elect to onside kick here.
Yeah, I would assume so, and we see number 10, Gomez, on our sideline, on the near sideline. I expect them to kick that way, as we see here a great onside kick that's going to be recovered by...
Well, it was loose for a very long time. I think the Chargers finally do recover it, though. It's almost as if the Chargers didn't want to recover it, but they finally do at about the 30-yard line. That's where they'll start this next drive with 5 minutes to go in the ball game. Raiders had a lot of opportunities there.
As we see here in replay, that ball actually popped out of Gomez's hand, and the Raiders had an opportunity to fall in it. They just couldn't, and again, that's just the way this game has gone. It's bounced all in favor of the Chargers.
Yeah, it looked like Jesse Montes was about to pounce on it and recover that onside kick. It goes sideways on him. He can't get it, and then finally the Chargers recover it at their own 31. They're going to keep it on the ground. That is number 15 with a carry. Cesar Belmonte is the first time he carries the ball this evening. So it'll be no yards, second and 10 from the 31. The main objective here for the Chargers is quite simply keep the ball inside a play and not stop the clock. We see some substitutions now here for the Chargers late in the ball game as they lead. And if anybody is still curious, it's Corpus Christi Miller 24, Victoria West 14. Of course, Miller, the District 14 5A Division 1 champs. Corpus Christi West, the fourth place team in that same district. Of course, the Raiders last week knocked off the second place team, Victoria East. And last week, Brownsville Veterans knocked off the third place team, Corpus Christi Veterans. So a lot of District 14 of action, District 14 from the Coastal Bend area, facing a lot of Valley teams. Quarterback snaps it with 2 seconds on the play clock. It's a keeper. And the Chargers are going to move the ball up to the 35-yard line. Gain of 4. Again, most importantly, the clock keeps turning. Keeps dwindling down to 0.
Timeout. PSJ North. This is their first of the half.
Timeout by Memorial Funeral Home.
So we've got a timeout, an official timeout with 3:14 remaining in the ballgame. It's, of course, the Chargers from Brownsville. Brownsville Vets, to be exact, 45. The Raiders, your hometown, PJ North Raiders, 21. It's been, from the get-go, a stiff challenge for the Raiders. The Chargers came out ready to play, needless to say, and they've taken advantage today of playing some great football, some miscues by the Raiders, And the Chargers are going to win a semifinal, regional semifinal game, perhaps for the first time in their history in football. I know they've done it in soccer, but I'm not sure if they've ever done it in football.
I do believe this is going to be the first time that they do make it on to the fourth round, Javi, and much deserved. You know, it's
definitely.
You would have liked to see this game.
Time out. Brownsville veterans. This is their second of the half.
Time out by Memorial Funeral Home.
You know, this is one of those games where you would have liked to see a back-and-forth game. Mm-hmm. I mean, you would have liked to see a game
that
was going to come down to possibly the last possession or maybe a lot closer in score. And it's just crazy, you know, how the tables were turned this year. The Raiders, you know, excited to have a host a home playoff game.
And, right.
You know, fortunately, as we see here, the punt almost blocked for the second time this game.
So the Raiders with Palacios with a good, solid return. Palacios tries to get up to the 40, maybe a couple yards shy. They're going to spot him down at the 38-yard line. So that's where the Raiders will take over. A lot of work to do. They got 3 minutes and 3 seconds. They trail by 4 scores. But I'll tell you what, Jonathan. You know, regardless of, you know, this outcome, which inevitably it is going to be the Chargers to win. And, of course, this is a proud production of KTRI, courtesy of PSG ISD. You know, we're a little bit biased at times because it is our home team. It is our home crowd here at beautiful PSG ISD Stadium. But, nonetheless, you know, I think the Raiders, I feel as though the fans feel. I'm a little bit shocked at how good the Chargers are. And, you know, I'm surprised, to be honest with you. But, you know, well-deserved win for the Chargers. But, again, my point being is that as Arredondo runs the ball for a good yardage past midfield, Julius Arredondo does, is the last 3 years the Raiders have been one of the best football teams the Rio Grande Valley has seen.
Yeah, you know, you're absolutely correct. Last year, you know, going into the
fourth. Official timeout for an injury.
Going to the fourth round and you know, school history, and that's a feat of its own. I think playing on Thanksgiving week is special in its own.
Yes.
And I tell everybody, you don't understand how special it is to play on Thanksgiving week. There's teams out there who wish that they could be here.
Right,
there's
right.
teams that don't even make it to
there's
the playoffs.
There's only a handful of teams left in the state of Texas that are out here.
And to be able to advance to the fourth round, as it looks like the Chargers are going to do here tonight, it's even more special because now you're playing into December.
Yeah.
That's what you look forward to when you start the football season, to have a chance to play for a state championship. And I think coming into the season, you know, the Raiders had a big target on their back. Everybody expected them to be at the state championship game. But I think people forgot that you have to take it game by game. And I said it to the beginning of the playoffs. The Raiders are great, but they're going to meet somebody that's going to match them. They got to win a playoff game. They got to win the bye district. They got to win the area championship. They got to get past the third round. Unfortunately for them, it's going to end for them here, Javi.
Well, and the other thing you take from that, and it's a good round of applause as we see the Brownsville Veterans Memorial player walk off the field on his own 2 feet. That's always a blessing right there. The other thing is, that's the beauty of sports, Jonathan, is how difficult it is to be a champion. You know, the Raiders fell last year in the regional championship game. They had a heck of a team. They got beat by a team just as good as they were. You know, that game could have gone 50-50 when you think about it, when you break it down. And that's sports. That's the beauty of football. That's the beauty of any athletic endeavor that you get into. How difficult is it just to get back to that championship game that they lost narrowly last year by 7? Unfortunately, they're not able to do it. But, again, that's just the difficulty of it, that you've got to be good and you've got to be lucky. And, unfortunately, this evening, you know, we've been fortunate enough to watch the Raiders the last 2 years. How well have they played? And just today just wasn't their day.
Yeah, you know, and you hit it right. You hit the nail on the coffin, Javi. It's sports. It's sports. That's the way it goes. And that was the message, as I mentioned, that Coach Ramirez told his team. Hey, this team gets dressed the same way we do. We all have to put shoulder pads on. As we see here, a pass to number 17, Isaac Willingham. Willingham's going to take a big hit right there at the end.
Yeah, Willingham inside the 20. Stays down for a second or two. Let's see if he gets up. He will.
Excuse me, I stand corrected. It hit the nail on the head. As we see here on replay again, a great tackle right there by the Chargers. And you know, you got to take it game by game. As you mentioned, he said, hey, we get dressed the same way.
Uh-huh.
We put
yeah,
on our helmet
definitely.
The same way. We got to play football the same way.
Right.
We're both playing the game. Someone is going to have to come out here victorious.
Well, that's what I always say. You know, there's got to be a winner or a loser. And it all depends on who plays better that day, who is a little bit more fortunate. And again, that's a great indication right there. Rendon makes a great, spectacular catch, but he's a foot out of bounds. If he's inbounds by a foot, well, hey, the Raiders, you never know. They may come back. They may come back. But, you know, it's a game of inches. All the credit in the world goes to Brownsville Veterans Memorial
prior
tonight.
To pass. Holding. Defense number 13. Half the distance to the goal. Automatic. First down.
Well, there we go. The first penalty that I can think of against the Chargers is assist. Half the distance to the goal. So it'll be first and goal for the Raiders at the 9-yard line. Raiders still fighting, trying to get on the board. They don't have too much time. 1:43. Playing for pride now are the Raiders.
Yeah, and you know, you feel for these seniors, Javi, who, you know, coming into this game, they had one mission, and that was to get to state. As we see a pass that's going to be intercepted here by the Chargers.
Nope, they're going to say incomplete. It hit the floor, narrowly missing that. And that would have been it, but instead the Chargers do not come up with interception in the end zone. That was Josh Bettis who says, I had it, and no, I don't have it. It'll be second and goal for the Raiders.
And you know, you feel for these seniors, Javi.
They accomplished a lot.
Because, you know, they've come in here, they've accomplished a lot. You've taken your team and you've done stuff that nobody has ever done in Raider history. Mm-hmm. And I've talked about teams in the past that who set the foundation for this Raider football team. As we see Arredondo back to pass here.
Well, he throws that into heavy traffic. The two receivers in the area, Fuentes and Rendon, but it comes up empty. I believe we have 1:33 remaining in the ball game. It'll be third and goal from the 9. There are a couple of incomplete passes. Shotgun formation for Julius. He's going to look, fire. He's got a man wide open, and that is caught for a Raider touchdown. Julius Arredondo to Diego Aparicio. The Raiders are still fighting and scratching and clawing. Touchdown, Raiders.
As we see here, that's just a wheel route. As you see, number 16. Going to be Diego Aparicio coming out of the backfield right there on that reception. A great pass and a great catch, you know, but might be a little bit too late, Javi, for the Raiders to mount the comeback as they're still down 18 points.
Well, it's a 62-yard drive by the Raiders. Cut into the lead, 45-27, 1:28. Things could start to get very interesting now. The extra point makes it 45-28 by Isasi. We got 1:28. I'm sure the Raiders are going to onside kick once again. Of course, they trail by 17 points, though. One score, definitely a chance. Two scores, maybe a doubt. But three, it's a lot to ask for.
I mean, the Raiders are really good at executing the onside kick. You know, they as we saw at the beginning, they recovered the first one. Again, we're not the officials. We have a different angle than they do. They have a better view than we do. Mm-hmm. We thought that maybe there wasn't kick catch interference. Who knows, right? The game might be different right now. The momentum might have shifted differently. They almost recovered an onside kick right here, you know, which gave the Chargers the ball back with about 4 minutes left in the game. And so, again, the ball just hasn't been able to bounce either way for the Raiders.
Well, the Raiders are going to more than likely try an onside kick. And you know, you're right, Jonathan. You know, you start the ball game with an onside kick, you know you're going to give up yardage. You're going to give up a short field if you don't recover it. And that's what the Raiders did. And Brownsville veterans, they did what they had to. 3 plays later, they were on the scoreboard. And after that, you know, just say, what, 7-0. You're down 7-0. No big deal. The thing was, next thing you know, the Raiders were down 14-0. And they just never recovered. They never got themselves back within 7 points. And the Chargers withstood the Raiders this evening. And the Chargers are going to be advancing. And it's still 28-14 over in Corpus as Miller, Corpus Christi Miller, leads Victoria West. Well, there you go. It's another onside kick. It gets by the 10 yards. And do the Raiders grab it? It's going to be very close. No, they're going to say it is the Chargers who make the...
Yeah, Palacios had an opportunity, and he had to wait just a fraction of a second more for it to pass.
Very close.
50-yard line. And again, Javi, the ball just did not bounce their way.
Game of inches. And the Chargers will recover that onside kick. So the Chargers will go into victory formation here. Oh, no, they're going to run it one more time. Trevion. And Trevion with the exclamation point up to the Raider 40-yard line. So that'll be first down, gain of 11. Excuse me, for Trio, Gilbert Trio with the carry. And now I assume the Chargers will go into victory formation. It's 24-14 over in the Miller Buccaneers Victoria West Warriors game. And, you know, we're going to – it's going to be interesting, John. I think Brownsville veterans has a legitimate chance with that defense, with the rugged running game. They can win a regional final. It would not shock me one bit if they did.
Absolutely, and I'm going to give credit to Coach Evans over at Brownsville Veterans, who is their offensive play caller. He used to be the head coach over at Southwest, went to Brownsville Veterans, became, I believe he was at Wesco East, went to Brownsville Veterans to become the offensive coordinator, instilled the triple option there, Javi, ran it to perfection today. This is like watching the Navy on a live, you know, as we see here, it's going to be the final snap of the game. And unfortunately for the Raiders, they're going to be on the losing end of this game.
Well, folks, it's official. The Chargers from Brownsville Veterans will win themselves a regional semifinal game here at beautiful PSJ Stadium by a score of 45-28. The Raiders' season, unfortunately, comes to a conclusion today. They had a tremendous season, winning back-to-back district championships, undefeated back-to-back seasons, regular seasons. Unfortunately, they fall a game short of what their realistic goal was to get back to the regional finals, but still, nothing to hang your head on. This was a superb football team. And unfortunately, you know, as they say, that's just the way the ball bounces sometimes, just not in your favor.
Yeah, Javi, you know, and the Raiders, you know, have nothing to be ashamed about. They set school history. Mm-hmm. You know, this senior football team did you know, laid the foundation for future Raiders. You know, and for Brownsville veterans, you know, congratulations to them. They did a great job coming in here and doing what they wanted to do, play football and hit the Raiders where they needed to hit them. And they did it today, showed on the scoreboard, showed it throughout the entire game.
Well, congratulations to head coach J.C. Ramirez, the entire staff over there at Brownsville Veterans Memorial, and, of course, to the players. Congratulations to you, young man. Well-deserved victory. Best of luck next week, whether you face a Corpus Christi team or a Victoria team. I hope you all come out victorious and represent the Valley, especially the way it should be done, with a team finally getting back to the state Final Four. Jonathan, any last words?
Oh, Javi, as you mentioned, just, you know, good luck to Brownsville as they continue to play next week. And, you know, they need to, you know, just enjoy the memories, Javi. It's not everybody gets to play in December. Congratulations to them. Much deserved victory today.
Well, I got to give one thanks, and that's to Mark, Danny, and the whole KTRI crew. It's been an absolute pleasure, as it is always. A lot of fun times. Unfortunately, it doesn't end. We were hoping to make one more trip next week somewhere, but we won't. But we're looking forward to hoping to get some success in basketball, maybe soccer, and most definitely baseball and softball. So on behalf of Jonathan, I'm Javi Martinez. I hope you enjoyed the game. Good night. God bless, and safe travels.